Right. So I've just been turning into, I don't know, for me, fatso at this point. And so I have to do something about the ballet again. I'm just going to talk about pointe shoes and about fitting them properly. Now, I have a really old pair. Now, the really old pair of pointe shoes, when you're putting on the old shoes and you don't put any of the any extra, you know what I mean, like the, let's say I'm not putting any of the fluffy on, nothing. You can use the socks. You can cut the socks, just the toes off the socks. That's a really good one. It's a cheap way to go. So you just use an old pair of socks and you cut them off there. Now, with that version, it's kind of like wool socks are better. So use the wool socks. And so then that's like, it's a stuffing, you know what I'm saying? Because they can give you blisters pretty quick. So and then wrap that type of sock around your toes. And so you're not just the bear in there. Although I've danced many times just with the bare feet in the new shoes, but the older they are, they start to spread out. I find they spread out in the tip zone, and when they're spreading out in the tip zone, you end up almost in a more danger place. It becomes a time when you can twist. You can twist just your toe. One way or the other, because here's your foot normally in the new shoe, but this it starts to spread out with the weight of your body over the time frame. The shoes start to mangle, and with the heat, and so you have to keep, if anything, adding more and more to the shoes. So I can have the brand new shoes, and see they're like really narrow. But over time, they will spread out, and same deal. You know, I'll have to add more and more stuffing in there. So no, I'm not really dancing. I don't feel like I'm able to do a pirouette show. Even though just what was it like a month ago, I was you know Miss Movado herself. You know, I was ready for grand jetés and everything. And I don't know. I guess life went another way for me. So here's a sock that I did, and it's just the tip of an old wool sock, and you literally just cut that off, and so that adds extra. And anything like if you're going to go barefoot with your pointe shoes, you're going to go through your shoes faster, simply because of the heat, the any kind of you're not having wicking, you know that action. They talk about the wicking of the sock. You're not going to have that action going on with the shoe. So you're going to be directly melting the shoe with your sweat. And so when you have the initial tights, you know, like you know the original, we're supposed to have the tights on. Oh my goodness, yeah. Oh, this is my old dog's fur. You know that? This is my old dog's fur. This is Rudy's, little Ruru. My gosh. I shouldn't even use it. You know what I'm saying? It's that amazing. And it's all I have of him. So I aside from photos, I actually keep all of my dog's fur. I have my And don't ask, but I guess the reason is the possible, you know. Do I want to clone them? You know, that question. Do I want to clone them? Because I was told that all I needed was their fur. So I've been carrying their fur around pretty much most of them. Yeah, so I have Chinoos, I have Tazzy Bears, and I have Rudy's. So, I don't have a little Naja, the Yorkshire Terrier, so I can't have her remade, you know, as a clone. But I don't know. I guess I just wanted the option in life, you know. The 50,000 clone money. Do I want them cloned? Even just to keep the question, you know, even if just to keep the question with me, because they were so like monumental as a major. Major players in my life on a daily basis, you know what I mean? Yeah, even if just to keep the question. So I've been dragging the dog here around like a witch. You know, they say that, you know, the witches are, what are we doing? I don't know, we have cauldrons and all of that. Well, maybe not. Maybe this is the new age witch, is we have to carry our dog fur around and wonder in the quandary, are we going, you know, are we going to clone them or not? And also back to my shoes, back to my point shoes. I know, I've been trying to make them last longer and last longer. So I've gone through all kinds of different goodies. I've made these little, oh gosh, what are they? It's just a little teeny piece of wood. Now it's a half piece of wood, and then the other half is more of a the sponge item, some kind of really hard, soft sponge, and then I've wrapped with tape around that. Now the wood is normally the wood that you put in a frame of a painting to give it that extra edge lift. So it's really easy to find that thin type of wood, and then you just cut it, and then you wrap it around with tape. Now this particular tape, it's just duct tape, but it's the pretty white one. So and then you take this, and it doesn't actually work for Freeds very well, not all Freeds, because of the tip, because of the way the tips are. They're more, I guess, more pinpoint. A few of my shoes, a few of the varieties are more pinpoint. But like I can take like the blocks, not the blocks, I keep calling them the blocks. What are these? The debutante ones, the debutante shoes. You can take any of these and just plunk them in there. And well, it isn't you actually, you know, getting as close to the ground as you normally used to, but it doesn't really matter. It just keeps the shoe lasting longer and longer. And so there it is. And you smush it in there and you just give it a good hold. And obviously, if you're going to be dancing Swan Lake or something, you have to put super glue in there first to hold it in place. I would not be letting it dancing at all if it was a loose thing, because it can slip out. It can slip out when you're dancing sometimes, just because we move our toes around. So yeah, you really have to fix it in there tight. And I don't know, this is just an update to point shoes because they can last, you know, very, very short while. We really want to make them last a little longer sometimes, you know. My gosh. Well, anyway, so was that my show for the day? Yeah, make sure use those items that help to wick away the sweat, and even if you're just like barefoot, if you're barefoot and then you use the, what is it, any of the sock type of item, if you're barefoot and you use the sock type of item, well, what's going to happen? It's going to get sweaty. You could end up with a really sweaty sock, and the shoe warms up and everything pretty quickly. However, same deal. You're going to melt your shoes. So it's always better to use the tights. Although I don't know, a lot of us just hate wearing the tights, don't we? So we could just use the, what do we call that? The footed? Not the footed, the, you know, ankle, the ankle tights. I don't know. Yeah, I don't. It used to be like the rules. We had to have the tights all the way through, you know, wrapped around our foot. But we've become much more lax about the whole situation and trainings, haven't we? So you don't have to. Well, anyway, everybody, I guess that's it. Gosh dang it! I'm sorry. I've just been eating bagels and, oh, cake, and I've just been a regular American naughty eater since I got back here. What can I say? Yeah, I think so. I think I gained like 5 pounds already. My gosh, my gosh. Well, anyway, so little angel is sleeping. Here, angel. One more talk of you. Look at her, isn't she beautiful? Yeah, she's a little anxious. She's a little anxious though. Yeah. She does better if I take her on a walk every morning. Yeah, doesn't she? Yeah, she's a good girl.